There's a statue of Brigham Young.
What?
And the flowers in Salt Lake City.
They're pretty.
They're pretty, for sure. A lot of tulips. A lot of tulips throughout the city. If you like that sort of thing.
Happy little flowers.
Yeah. We are now at the
Beehive
House, and this served as a home to Brigham Young. He was the second president of the Church of Latter-day Saints, and this is his house. The name came from the, it looks like a beehive up there at the top. It's kind of hard to see from down here. And then directly beside it here is the Lion House. And if I read this correctly, the Lion House is where his wives and children stayed. So we're going to attempt to go in here and check out this place. I'm not sure if they're open or if they let you film inside, but we're going to give it a shot here.
It was called the Territory of Deseret. And
I wonder why. I see that. I've been seeing that.
Yeah, it's a term out of the Bible. It means honeybee, and of course beehive. The beehive symbolizes unity and hard work, and
sure.
So we're working together. And it's Utah's symbol as well, the beehive is. And do you kids know what a handcart, how they did a handcart in those days?
Yeah.
Well, a handcart was not much bigger than this table. It was about this big. And they put all the belongings they could bring. You can't imagine, that wasn't very much. You probably take that much in your car when you're traveling on a trip, don't you? So as a result of that policy, there were very few problems with the Indians. We did a good job of Truman O and you see it, they're really professional considering even later on Brigham sent.
You know, as we were walking up, oh, this is the cape he was wearing?
Yes, that's the cape that he was wearing when he first came. And these are photographs of Brigham. I think that first one was taken in Nauvoo of Brigham in 1846, and then it goes through his life up to here. And this was taken in 1876, about the time of his, he died a year later in 1870. He saw the vision again.
Okay.
This was his tool chest, and all the tools on there that have a BY on it, we know belong to him. But he was very good, and he believed in doing things, everything that in a person's life and the things that they did should be done with quality. And he also believed in industry. He didn't believe in just giving people jobs. At 8 years old, she'd been here about 6 years. She was just plain tired. She'd been through all those trials and persecutions. And she said
could
she
you
wanted
imagine,
to
could
retire.
Could you imagine packing up your whole life?
Yeah, I know. And so she retired, and his first plural wife, her name was Lucy Ann Decker, then became right to his office, and then that door connected to the president's office. So
sure.
The same thing, if they came in the president's office and needed some privacy or whatever. So that secretary desk in the far right-hand corner is original that belonged to him, and the cane, and the hat's interesting. You want to try the hat on, one of the hats? It's a beaver hat, and they would, when I think of beaver hats, I kind of thought of Davy Crockett
look
or something like that, you know?
You got a beaver hat on.
But they would actually take the fur from the beaver. Oh, this is family room, and they would meet in there for family prayers at night.
That's where my kids would all ignore me and play the switch.
She was just born, but she was
That's a harp.
She wrote a book about Brigham Young's
home. And it's this delightful book about their life and the rooms, what they did, and how they're going out on the balcony.
Look at the shoes here. Tiny feet. This was his daughter, Brigham Young's daughter?
Yes.
Okay.
So Lucy had 7 children, and Marianne had 6.
Oh, okay.
And then this is the formal room. No, it isn't. Okay, it's granite.
So this house is made of this adobe brick?
Mm-hmm. But the temple is out of granite. There's a mine or a... Lucy was tired, and she wanted to no longer have to take care of the house. So she sold it to John W. Young, who was a son of Mary Ann and Brigham. And he was in the railroad business.
Oh, my goodness, look how beautiful.
He was in the railroad business. Found this back portion. Now, back here, it was just kind of a lean-to, and I think it's where the boys and the helpers lived, because most of the workers that worked here lived here too. And so they tore this whole thing down. The kitchens were below, and it went from 14 rooms to 27 rooms. Part that he changed the most. So but unfortunately, in 5 years, he lost
smoke detector. Now this room is elaborate right here. Oh. All right, so this part's been restored. So it looks a little different than the rest of the house.
How meticulous.
I missed that part. What did she say?
So see the wallpaper?
Yes.
It's not wallpaper. It's hand stenciled.
Wow.
After Lucy sold the property and John W. inherited it, and then the church Brigham's time and wanted to have it in Brigham's period, and that still is dated 1854.
Look how beautiful those dishes are.
Here's the kitchen in the Beehive House. Stove. My grandmother had dishes like this.
Here's another original part of the house.
I guess that's the right time period.
So all of these things are things that would have been in the store at that time. Look at the shoes. Not only are they little, but notice there are no left and right feet.
Oh yeah, they're all
they
the same.
Didn't do that at that time.
Man, they're tiny.
I know.
What if you have big feet? So well, I mean, they wouldn't kind of fit.
We've grown some in size, but not that much. Brigham was 5'10".
Now we're out in the garden of the Beehive House.
I think we should get lunch at the Lion House.
Anyway.
Thank you for watching our video of the tour of the Beehive.
So these rooms are each where one of his wives slept.
Each one of those gables.
Gables, excuse me. Get it right, Trevor.
There's a bunch of them.